I heard you mention that you don't do the leather, and what you wear is also not of animals. So
right.
How do you get around that?
I bought a Tesla. That everything inside the car is vegan and it doesn't take any fossil fuel. My job, I have a size 15, 16 shoe, is to have the least amount of footprint on the planet when I leave. So right. I literally made a decision. So you can be plant-based, but when you're vegan, you think about everybody and everything else. You think about the planet, you think about the person next to you, the animals, and yourself. Mm-hmm. So being a vegan, it used to sound like saying I was a vampire, and people didn't understand it. But I understood that the better I do, the nicer I am, the happier I am, anything around me is happy. Everything around me is great.
Me too.
Do you think being a vegan made you a happier person?
Oh,
were
yeah.
you sad before that?
Yeah, why you're sad is you're eating death, right? So if you become a casket, how happy can you be being a casket?
In a graveyard. You
right.
graveyard the animals.
Yeah, that's crazy. Dick Gregory decided, he said when he became a vegetarian, didn't know what it was, when he saw a sheriff kick his 9-month pregnant wife. And he was like, I would never be that evil or that angry to anything.
Wow.
So he wouldn't even do it to an animal. So I looked at people and they were like, well, animals are here for us to eat. That's so crazy. Because at one time, black people were considered farm animals. So at one time, we were that.
Right.
Why it was no problem to lynch us. It was no problem to kill us. No problem to take the woman. No problem to take the kid. It's the same mentality. There's no problem to take a cow. No problem to take a calf.
For both of you,
detachment.
Who are very embedded into the black community, black people love you, John. Black people, you already know, you a black legend.
Mm. Oh, God.
Why do you think that black people aren't into being vegan?
They are.
They are.
That's the biggest rush. We're the largest. It moved from 1% to 3% with Dr. Sebi, with Nipsey, with Dick Gregory, with Angie.
All the vegan vendors now, they're every new vegan place, it's African American.
Yeah. Pizzeria, we got plant-based pizzeria in Atlanta.
Well, when I get people call me at the station and they're looking for healthy options anywhere between Slauson and La Brea in LA, they don't have them.
Three places.
Right. I'm from the South. They don't have vegan.
14 places.
It's coming, Tammi.
You can't get away because the first show I was going to do was about vegan food in the country. So where you are, in Atlanta, plant-based pizzeria, you have Vegan Soul, you got Tusili's.
Oh, uh-huh. Slutty Vegan.
Slutty Vegan, all
Slutty
of
Slutty Vegan, which is doing very well.
Right.
Very.
They all do well.
Are there any in Houston?
House of Chicken. House of Chicken, yeah, Vegan Soul. Vegan House of Chicken in Orlando. In Houston, you said, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a great place right downtown.
Just punch it in Yelp. They're just pop. Like today, someone probably opened up today. And in terms of the fashion, mm-hmm. right now, you have to look at it. You have to look at it like it's one of the biggest lifestyle shifts in our time ever.
Yeah.
This is a huge lifetime shift. So we're on ground floor. And the entrepreneurs see this. There are people who only think about entrepreneurship. We, on the other hand, are thinking about people, and we just so happen. I could be doing other things. I so happen to be able to make a living at it. And I feel like I'm growing an empire with what I'm doing because we're on the ground floor, right?